In the movie First Man, a very Ryan Gosling-looking Neil Armstrong drops a bracelet on the moon in memory of his daughter. But is there really a bracelet up there? Did Armstrong actually leave something like this behind? And how can we find out? Let's talk about it in seven elements. First off, Neil and Janet Armstrong really did have a daughter named Karen, who passed away at 2.5 following a fight with brain cancer. Her death may have spurred a grief-stricken Armstrong to apply for Project Gemini, stick with NASA through rigorous trainings and dangerous test flights to ultimately set foot as first man on the moon. So it makes sense he might honor Karen by leaving something behind. In life, as in the film, Armstrong didn't talk about Karen after her death, even with his wife and sons. So the moon bracelet drop is far from a certain thing. In fact, in his later years, he was asked point blank whether he'd left something on the moon for Karen. He said he did not. So, case closed, right? There's no bracelet? Maybe not. But some see this denial as more a reflection of Armstrong's private nature and less as an absolute truth. They believe he may have left something and simply kept that act to himself, which is why this mystery exists. Still, the proof seems simple enough. If it's up there, we could see it, right? Yes, of course, if we were close enough or had a strong enough telescope. But the moon is so far away, and a bracelet so small that none of our earthbound tools come close to being able to resolve or see something that size. Even the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, launched by NASA in 2009 and circling as close as 12 miles above the surface, doesn't deliver images with enough detail. Like this one of the Apollo 11 site, complete with equipment from the first moon landing. You can even see footpaths where Armstrong walked. The bracelet would be somewhere in this scene, but we're still not close enough. Are there any clues in the video or audio recordings from the landing? Again, no luck. A TV camera was operating during the entire moonwalk. Armstrong exits the lander first,
that's one small step for man,
followed by Buzz Aldrin, second man on the moon, which could be a good sequel. They spent a little over 2 hours on the surface, placing an American flag, taking pictures, setting up experiments, gathering rocks, and chatting with President Nixon. But the astronauts aren't always in frame, and none of the audio, photos, or other video sources give away a bracelet drop either, which could mean it never happened. Or if it did, Armstrong wanted to keep it private, and not, say, have it featured prominently in a Hollywood movie. Neither Armstrong nor Aldrin ever talked about a memento for Karen. But what about the 10 others who've been on the moon? Maybe they saw something. No luck here either. It turns out the moon, in addition to not being made of cheese, is actually really big, about a fourth the size of the Earth, and with more surface area than all of the African continent. So you're not just gonna happen upon something the size of a bracelet. More to the point, the six lunar landings were spread all over the near side of the moon, with Armstrong here and the next closest landing hundreds of miles or kilometers away. And none of these other brave visitors reported seeing anything out of place.
Phone home.
Fascinating.
Every astronaut was allowed to bring a personal preference kit, or PPK, on their flights. A small bag that was loaded with whatever the astronauts wanted. If Armstrong took a bracelet, he'd probably have packed it here. Often, PPKs were loaded with coins, mission patches, flags, jewelry, and that sort of thing. So a bracelet would fit right in. Aldrin brought bread and wine and took communion during their mission. Later flights saw $2 bills, a golf club and golf balls, even a family portrait, which is still on the surface to this day. So, what was in Armstrong's PPK? We know he took jewelry for his wife and mother, a scout badge, a fraternity pin, wood and cloth remnants from the Wright brothers' first plane, and more. He's talked about these items and even signed his name to some. But again, he never admitted to bringing something for his daughter. NASA was so thorough, though, they'd also have astronauts write down everything they packed in their kit before their flights. Here's Charlie Duke's list, with mention of that family photo. But unfortunately, if Armstrong listed something for Karen, we wouldn't know. His manifest has yet to be revealed. At this point, the bracelet story seems like a long shot. No photos, no audio, Armstrong denied it, and so forth. But a small detour Armstrong took while on the moon strikes some as a little odd. This detour is depicted in the movie and shown in this map of the landing site with Armstrong and his path in yellow. They've been on the moon nearly 2 hours now, and there's still some work to be done. But instead, Armstrong, on his own, quietly makes an unscheduled and unannounced trek to this crater. He's silent for 6 minutes, out of camera view for 3 minutes, and stands at the edge for as much as 80 or 90 seconds. He snaps photos to make one panoramic image, but that's it. And so it's here, alone, out of contact with Earth, and the farthest either astronaut would venture, that maybe, just maybe, he left something behind. It's this belief, held by some of his family, that created this moment in the movie. The bracelet's a beautiful part of the story, but did it actually happen? What do you think? Could you pull off such a private act with the whole world watching? Will we ever know what's up there? And what would you leave on the moon? Let us know in the comments below. For more videos just like this one, please subscribe. Thank you for watching, and remember,
let's go again.
We need to fail down here so we don't fail up there.
Neil, I was sorry to hear about your daughter.
I think it would be unreasonable to assume that it wouldn't have some effect.
I married Neil because I wanted a normal life.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.